We should make one note about time functions in Excel. Most people are familiar with PI client tools or system manager tools and our time abbreviations. Those would be the asterisk for now and the T for today and Y for yesterday and the offsets that we have. So for example, asterisk minus 2H would be now minus 2 hours or 2 hours ago. It's important to realize that Excel has time functions as well, dynamic time functions. And while both the PI time abbreviations and the Excel time abbreviations will both function correctly, either as entered into dialog boxes or when used as cell references, it's often preferable to use the Excel functions for your reports. And the reason is very simple. Here's an example where I have the PI time formats of T for today, Y for yesterday, which means yesterday at midnight, the asterisk, which means now, and asterisk minus 4H, which means now minus 4 hours ago. And in column D, I have the Excel equivalents. You can see this is today, left and right paren, is the equivalent of T. The equivalent of yesterday is today, left, right paren, minus 1. The equivalent of now is equals now, left, right paren. And now minus 4 hours is now, left, right paren, minus 4 over 24. The big difference in the formats is that Excel bases everything on a unit of days. So if you want to go back 4 hours, you have to say minus 4 over 24, as opposed to 4H. And the reason we prefer people to use Excel time functions as opposed to the PI time functions is that in the Excel time function, you can actually see the date and time. And this is really important because Excel doesn't have a natively updating function like Processbook does. So if you update your screen and then you walk away for 20 minutes and come back and look at your report, you're not really sure when that ran if you use the PI time formats, because there may not be a date and time on there of when the report ran. However, if you use the Excel time formats and you run a report, you update the spreadsheet, that date and time is on the spreadsheet. So if you have a start time and an end time for your array of values, that start time and end time will be there at the heading of your worksheet. So we often do prefer you use the Excel notations as opposed to the PI notations. But again, either will work, either entered into the dialog box or used as cell references.